Hello students, we are discussing the chapter solutions and up to the last lecture we have discussed colligative properties. So we have discussed two colligative properties, that is lowering of vapor pressure and elevation of boiling point. Today we are going to discuss a third colligative property, that is depression of freezing point. So let us first understand what is a freezing point. See, freezing point is what? It's a point, it's a temperature at which the liquid phase and the solid phase of a liquid are in equilibrium with each other. That is, at this temperature, the vapor pressures of solid phase and the liquid phase are same. Say for example, there is a liquid whose vapor pressure at some temperature is this. This is the temperature and this is the vapor pressure. So this is the vapor pressure. Now I have told you all already that vapor pressure depends upon temperature. Vapor pressure temperature वर depend कर. त्याच्यामुळे आपण जर temperature वाढवत गेला तर vapor pressure वाढत जाणार. पण temperature जर कमी करत गेला, if we decrease the temperature, then the vapor pressure will also go on decreasing. So suppose this is the vapor pressure. Now as you go on decreasing the temperature, see, the vapor pressure will also go on decreasing. Now suppose this is the vapor pressure curve of the solid solvent. Okay, solid solvent, see, this is A, B, this is the vapor pressure of solid solvent. Now this is the liquid solvent. Now liquid solvent, as you are decreasing the temperature, the vapor pressure will also go on decreasing. Now at this point, you see, at this point, say, instead of calling this point as B, let me take this as B. So at this point, this solid solvent and this pure solvent, that is liquid, they are in equilibrium with each other. That is, at this point, the vapor pressures of both pure solvent as well as solid solvent are equal. So this temperature is the freezing point of the pure solvent. Now you are aware that when a non-volatile solute is added to a solvent, the vapor pressure decreases. This is called as lowering of vapor pressure. So now if a solid, non-volatile solute is added, then the solution that is formed will have a vapor pressure lower than the pure solvent, say here. Now as you decrease the temperature, vapor pressure goes on decreasing like this. See, now at the temperature TF0, earlier pure solvent, jo pure solvent hota, to freeze zalela hota TF0 la. Par ata TF0 la solution jo hai, to freeze hot nahi. टेम्परेचर आणखीन कमी करा लागणार. सो ऍट दिस टेम्परेचर फायनली देर इज दिस इंटरसेक्शन बिटवीन दिस टू कर्व्स, कर्व्स ऑफ द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ सोल्यूशन अँड द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ सॉलिड सॉल्वंट. देर इज अन इंटरॅक्शन इन, सो हियर दिस इज द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ द सोल्यूशन. ओके, ऍट दिस करस्पॉन्ड टेम्परेचर करस्पॉन्डिंग टू दिस इंटरसेक्शन. Now see, TF, that is the freezing point of solution, is lesser, lower as compared to the freezing point of the pure solvent. See here, this decrease in the freezing point due to the addition of non-volatile solute is called as depression of freezing point. So again, I would like to revise. Freezing point is the temperature at which the solid phase of the solvent and liquid phase of the solvent are in equilibrium with each other. That is, they have the same vapor pressure. Now when a non-volatile solute is added to a solvent to produce solution, vapor pressure is found to be lesser. This is called as lowering of vapor pressure. Now to freeze it, you will have to reduce the temperature. See, at this temperature, there is an intersection between the vapor pressure curve of the solid solvent and vapor pressure curve of this solution. This is called as freezing point of the solution. Now you can easily see that TF0 is greater than TF. That is, the freezing point of solution is lesser as compared to the freezing point of the pure solvent. This is called as lowering of freezing point, ya fir depression of freezing point. Okay, so you can easily understand from this graphical representation also. Now it is observed that the depression in freezing point, how do you get the depression of freezing point? Delta Tf, this is equal to what? Tf0 minus Tf. Depression of freezing point is observed to be directly proportional to molality in case of dilute solution. So for dilute solutions, it is observed that delta Tf is directly proportional to the molality, and therefore delta Tf is equal to Kf into m. This constant Kf is called as freezing point depression constant. This is called as freezing point depression constant. Freezing point depression constant. This is also called as cryoscopic constant. This is also called as cryoscopic constant. See, for dilute solutions, also observe करना था कि delta Tf depression of freezing point जो है, ये directly proportional है molality. So therefore delta Tf is equal to Kf into m. Kf is a constant. The constant law पर बंदो freezing point depression constant की हुआ cryoscopic constant. Now if m is equal to 1, जर molality त्या solution ची 1 झालेली असेल तर बघा काय मिळतं आपल्याला. Delta Tf is equal to Kf. Kf is what? Cryoscopic constant. So what is cryoscopic constant then? So cryoscopic constant is the depression in freezing point produced by one molar solution containing non-volatile solute. जर non-volatile solute add केला त्याच्यामुळे जर 1 molar solution form होत असेल तर जो डिप्रेशन येणार फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट मध्ये, कमी येणार फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट मध्ये, दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज क्रायोस्कोपिक कॉन्स्टंट. सो क्रायोस्कोपिक कॉन्स्टंट इज द डिप्रेशन इन फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय वन मोलल सोल्यूशन ऑफ a non-volatile solute. So this is the cryoscopic constant. See, delta Tf is equal to Kf into m. So therefore Kf is equal to what? Delta Tf upon m. So what are the units? Delta Tf, change in the temperature, so therefore it is Kelvin. And this is molality. What is the unit of molality? Moles per kilogram. So therefore this is Kelvin. Kilogram will go to the numerator. Kelvin kg per mole. This is the unit of cryoscopic constant. Okay. Now you know what is molality? Molality is number of moles of a solute present in 1 kg of the solvent. So therefore molality is equal to number of moles of solute can be calculated by mass of solute upon molar mass of solute upon mass of the solvent per kg. So we will divide this by 1000 because this is in grams. So we will divide this by 1000. Therefore this is equal to W2 into 1000 upon W1 into M2. So therefore delta Tf becomes equal to what? Kf into 1000, this one, W2 upon W1 into M. So this is an important formula. You will need this formula for solving numerical problems in your board exams as well as in competitive exams. So from this, we can determine the molar mass of the solute. अपन जो सॉल्यूट डिसॉल्व करतो प्युअर सॉल्वेंट मध्ये आणि ज्याच्यामुळे हा डिप्रेशन ऑफ फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट येतो तो जर त्याचा जर मोलर मास कॅल्क्युलेट करायचा असेल तर हा फॉर्म्युला आपल्याला उपयोगात पडू शकतो. सो देअरफॉर एम टू इज इक्वल टू व्हॉट, याला इकडे घेऊन येऊया, दिस इज इक्वल टू 1000 डब्ल्यू टू इंटू के एफ अपॉन डब्ल्यू वन इंटू डेल्टा टी एफ. दिस इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग मोलर मास ऑफ द सॉल्यूट. सो आई थिंक यू हैव कंप्लीटली अंडरस्टूड डिप्रेशन ऑफ फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट. आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट अगेन. डिप्रेशन ऑफ फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट इज द डिक्रीज इन द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट प्रोड्यूस्ड ड्यू टू द एडिशन ऑफ अ नॉन वोलेटाइल सॉल्यूट. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन अ नॉन वोलेटाइल सॉल्यूट इज एडेड. See, earlier when the solvent is pure, solvent molecules are close by, so there is greater force of attraction in between them. So it is easy to freeze them. Now when a solid solute is added, which is non-volatile, now in between these solvent molecules, there are solute particles. So therefore, now the forces of attraction between the solvent molecules has decreased. कारण त्याच्यामध्ये आता solute particles आहेत. So now the force of attraction is weaker now, so to freeze it you have to decrease the temperature even further. Okay, so this is the reason why there is depression in the freezing point. So depression in freezing point is because of the lowering of vapor pressure and because of the presence of the solute particles in between solvent molecules, which reduce the forces of attraction between the solvent molecules. Okay, so this is the formula for delta TF. Okay, delta TF is equal to KF 1000 into W2 upon W1 into M2. By using this formula, हा फॉर्म्युला वापरून आपण मोलर मास डिटरमाइन करू शकतो सॉल्यूटचा जो आपण ऍड केलेला आहे. ओके, सो दिस इज द ऍप्लिकेशन ऑफ दिस. इफ यू आर फाइंडिंग इट डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टँड, देन यू हॅव टू रेफर बॅक टू द ओल्डर लेक्चर्स. याच्या आधीचे जे लेक्चर्स आहेत ते तुम्हाला बघा लागणार, म्हणजे मग तुमचं कन्सेप्ट क्लिअर होणार आणि हे पुढचे व्हिडिओ समजायला तुम्हाला मदत मिळणार. आणि एखाद्या वेळेस समजायला डिफिकल्टी झाली तर ते तुम्हाला दोनदा व्हिडिओ बघायला लागणार, देन इट विल बिकम क्लिअर. ओके, सो कीप वॉचिंग ऑल द लेक्चर्स, कीप स्टडिंग ऑल्सो, कीप प्रॅक्टिसिंग रायटिंग द आन्सर्स फॉर युअर बोर्ड एक्झाम्स एज वेल एज फॉर युअर एंट्रन्स एक्झाम्स. थँक्यू व्हेरी मच.